quick tutorial on the math functions. So I think for exercise number two, you're going to need square root and also power. Okay, I'm going to show you how you can use the math library. Can we just create a class over here? Let's just say class. You can say math examples. And we're going to need a main method there. We're going to show you how you can do it. Okay?
If you go to the API page
for the math class, you will see there are many, many methods over there. Okay? So let me just go there quickly to show you. So if you Google Java API and then math, and then if you go there, let's say it doesn't matter if you choose version 7 or version 8, it doesn't really change, it doesn't matter. If you go there, there's a class called math over there. You can see that here, hopefully now the return time makes sense to you. It certainly says that, let me choose the one that's easy to see. For example, for absolute value, ABS, that's the name of the method which takes one parameter, A, of type double, and also returns a double. Okay, for example, if you say absolute value of minus 2, it's going to return 2 back to you. And also, the one I'm going to show you, there are two methods that I'd like to show you. One is called power, and this is to return A raised to the power of B. Okay, you're gonna pass two double values there, and it's going to return the double back to you. And the next thing I will show you is square root. And you can pass a single double value, and then it's going to return back to you the double value for its square root. Okay, that's how you see the parameter at return type. And the word static here, I briefly explained on maybe about Monday's lecture 2 weeks ago. Anyway, in that lecture there, I said that whenever you see static, that means you can directly use the class name to call the method. Okay, let's see how we can do that. Okay, you can refer to the API yourself later on. Okay, let's see. First of all, let's see, calculate 2 to the power of 10, which we know is 1024. So we can do that. You got different ways of doing this. You can use a variable to capture the results. Let's say double 2 to the power of 10, for example. I think you cannot start a variable with number. So 2 to the power of 10. Okay. It's assigned to, so now we can say math dot power here. So 2 to the power of 10. And remember the return type of this method here is double. That's why I'm using a double variable to capture that. And you can see we're using the name of the class, comMath, and then dot pow. Okay, let's see. You can say system.out.println. And 2 to the power of 10 is. And now we can say 2 like that. Okay, if you launch the program, let's see, 1024. Okay, no surprise, should be easy. So that's something you can do when you want to do the formula for the points, right? You can say x1 minus x2 to the power of 2. That's something you can do, okay, to the power of something. Another thing I would like to go through would be the square root, okay? Calculate square root of, let's say, 144, which should be 12. So double square root of 144 is assigned to math dot square root 144. Oops. And then I can say system dot out dot print line. Square root of 144 is, and then the variable name. Okay, let's try that. Okay, 12.0. Now, let me give you a 1 minute exercise to try on the board, and then we're done. Calculate the following number for me using
these two functions, using these two methods,
the power and also the square root. Okay, now I'm going to put the expression here.
Let's say the square root of let's say 23. It doesn't really make mathematical sense. I just want you to try to see how you can build a complicated expression. Let's say to the power of 3 plus and then square root of 3 to the power of 5. Okay, how about that? Let's say you can use, you have to, for the power expression here, you cannot say 3 times 3 times 3 5 times. That's not allowed. You gotta use the power method and also use the square root method for the math class, these two. How do you evaluate this expression here? It is certainly possible to write a one-line expression for this, but I would suggest try to break this into different parts. So you may want to calculate 3 to the power of 5 first, and then to say, accordingly, what should be the square root of that number, right? And then plus that, whatever that number is, and then take the square root. That might be easier for you.
Okay? Give it a try, and then I'll give you the solution for both versions. Yeah, maybe try 2 minutes, and then I'll go over that in 1 minute, and then we're done. Let me write it down. Calculate square root of 23 to the power of 3. Plus the square root of 3 to the power of 5. Okay, maybe 1 more minute, and then we'll go over a solution. Are you done?
Good man. Good. Yeah, I'm sure the formula you need for your exercise number 2 is much less complicated than this, but I just want you to practice.
Okay, let's go over that.
Version 1. Let's break
each part into a separate variable. Okay? So let's do double. Let's say 3, let me be a little bit consistent with naming. That's a power, 3 to the power of 5, okay? It's assigned to math.power 3 to the power of 5, okay? And then I'm going to have square root of that, square root of power 3 to the power of 5, right? I'll just say underscore in between. You can name it whatever way you like. Math dot square root, and then here I'm going to say power 3 to 5. Okay? Okay, and now I'm done with this part here. And now I'm going to do this part. So square root of 23. Square root of 23. Math dot square root of 23. And now square root of 23 to the power of 3. Double power square root of 23 to the power of 3. Yeah, the naming is really bad, but you can choose a better naming than mine. Okay. It's gonna be equal to this one's interesting. We're gonna say math power here. So now we're going to do square root 23 to the power of 3. Okay, we're almost done. So now we're going to say, okay, I wouldn't bother. I should say addition. Use addition here. It's assigned to this number here plus this number here. Okay, so square root of 3 to the power of 5 plus this number here. Okay, finally, double answer is assigned to the square root of the addition. Math. Whatever value it is. Okay, you can just send the L dot print line. Answer is plus answer. Okay, let's see what it is. Yeah, something like that. Okay, is 5, is that what you got?
Yep.
Okay, very good. So let me show you one line solution. Okay, you might prefer this one instead, so you don't have to worry about the name of the variable. Okay, I'm going to show you now. Okay, so now let me say double one line answer is assigned to. Okay, I'm going to change to a new line. Okay, I'm going to type this slowly.
At the top level, we're going to take the square root of something. Okay, at the top level.
So we're going to say math dot square root of something.
And this something here happens to be an addition of two numbers, right?
So we're going to say something, or to put question mark here, plus something. Okay, on the left,
it is something to the power of 3. Agree? Okay.
So now we're going to say math, the power, so it says something to the power of 3.
Okay, and that something there is the square root of 23.
That something there is math dot square root of 23. So now I'm done with the left-hand side.
For the right-hand side, easier. So it's basically the square root of something.
So replace question mark by math dot square root of something here.
And that something is 3 to the power of 5.
So math dot power 3 to the power of 5. And this should give you the same result. Let's try again. So it's in the outer print line. One line answer is one line answer. Yep, exactly the same. Okay, do you actually get it about how to do one-line answer? It's not too difficult, right? You just have to understand
in a mathematical formula which one is going to be evaluated first. So we're going top-down.
Okay. Which one to use, again, is completely up to you. I personally prefer the one-line solution, actually. You don't have to worry about the names or the variables, which can get very ugly, you can see. Yeah, very. I would say it's really senseless. Okay, any questions about this? Hopefully this will help you to do the some methods in the